Robots can help us humans in so many different ways. We repay them by making them compete against one another. In this next segment, we check out real-life robo-competitors. Let's take a look. After-school activities like chess club or soccer are great ways to make friends, learn teamwork, or stay fit. But they're not great at teaching about robots. Thankfully, some lucky students get to be part of the robotic future right now. And it's all thanks to teachers like Phet Pease, an award-winning instructor and robotics club coach at Woodrow Wilson Middle School in San Diego.
Honestly, I love everything about my job. I get to continue learning and get paid for it. I get to play with all these fun toys. I get to tinker, I get to be creative, and I get to hang out with students who are just so entertaining and amusing, and they just brighten my day. It's the best profession, hands down.
Today, Phet is going to show us what it takes to coach a robotics team and how she makes teaching science, technology, engineering, and math fun.
Right now, robotics, it seems really sterile. You have all these like metal pieces and it's kind of intimidating. So I wanted to recruit more girls, and a lot of my students are into crafting and art.
Phet is always seeking unconventional ways to reach students that might not know how dynamic STEM and robotics can be. Phet looks for inspiration from our sponsor, the Infosys Foundation USA. The Pathfinders Institute provides in-person teacher training, as well as online professional learning for teachers to connect with a virtual community, create lesson plans, network, share instructional videos, and even integrate things like crafting and art into robotics projects.
Look at some of the examples my students have made. Here are paper circuits. When the circuits are closed and you press on the heart, the sun glows. Paper mechatronics have this little fun alien move up and down. They use some gears in order to revolve the moon around the Earth. We also work with bigger robots, robots that we use for competition.
These competitions are a focus of the robotics clubs, and they have 6 to 8 weeks to prepare. All the teams competing have to navigate the same game board, using robots assembled from things like building bricks and even a robot vacuum. Teams have 2 minutes to complete all of their tasks, navigating the course and knocking over goals like pom-poms to gain points. Every team is given the exact same components, so it's skill, creativity, and hard work that determine who succeeds. Phet's team is actually here today to show us what being in robotics club is really like.
Let's go ahead and code out the light calibration.
Once a team knows what challenges their robots will face, they work together to figure out the best way for their robots to complete their tasks.
All right, team, are you guys ready to run some robots?
Yes!
Elena's robot vacuum has to drive straight, make a precise turn, knock over palms.
It missed that palm. Oh, it got one palm down.
And then foam cubes and stop at just the right moment.
Woo!
The hardware is run by Danity's code. And while this wasn't a bad run, the team knows they can do better.
Maybe I would have it go longer and the hook would be able to hit more of the pom-poms.
My favorite part about competing in the competitions is to just like see how creative the other teams can be, and I love seeing how the other teams work together.
All of my friends made this coding, and we made a robot. A simple line of code like this can make everything that we do today.
Nathan's robot navigates up the ramp based on sensors that follow black tape on the board. But since we're doing this outside today, the sunlight makes it hard for the robot to detect.
I think I had trouble finding the line.
Time for some recalibrations.
I have to work with Danny to figure out the coding. She will change the value of the threshold, but I need to figure it out what the threshold is.
Trial and error are key to learning robotics, coding, and building a championship team. The kids tweak the code until the sensors are working just right.
I'm gonna try it again.
The robot finally finds its way up the hill, makes a sharp turn, stops to knock some palms off.
Yay!
And finally, uses its arm grab to drop a plush onto the game board. Not flawless, but a lot better.
Yay! Great job!
My favorite part of the competition is having fun while come up with ideas and learn from my mistakes.
What I love about robotic competition is seeing other people's designs and seeing how mine looks, and that way, for next year, I can learn what to do.
I can't wait to see how my students do at the robotics competition. They're gonna do fabulous, and I'm just so excited to see the end results.
Yay! Yay!
There's so many cool applications of robotics. Take a class, join your local league, join a club, come explore it. Robotics is here waiting for you. Who knows, you could land the next Mars rover.